Before we start the video, I would like to take a moment to say thanks to all my patrons. I wouldn't be able to keep doing this without you, so thank you so much for all your support. I'd also like to say thanks to Richter and Joshua for their tier 3 sub this month, and special thanks to James and Modilla for their tier 4 sub this month. In this video, we're going to add a fall animation to our fox so that when we start jumping, he will fall on the way down. As you can see, he switches between two different animations here. So that's exactly what we're going to implement in this video. To implement this, we will have to create a new animation. So let's select the player, go to Rig, and create a new animation clip and call it Fall. I think we should go to the assets and select the animations folder and select Complete and call it Fall. So different things needs to move on the fox, and of course you can do it exactly as you want, but I'm going to hit record and move it to 1 second. Then I'm going to move his head a bit forward. I am going to move this right arm a bit back and stretch it out a bit like that. And the left arm is going to be twisted up a bit. And then the legs, I'm going to move the front left a bit out like this so that he like stretched it out to land kinda, and the back leg is going to go back just like that, and he's also going to stretch that out. So I want it to look like he's trying to land here. We could also take the leg and move it a bit down if you want to, like so. So the animation all in all would be like this. He falls, he would look like that. So that's my example of a fall animation. I'm going to stop recording. Click the little arrow and create a clip and go to my animations and select the body and write body underscore fall. Here I'm going to go to the fall animation, select everything, control A, control C, go to body fall again and paste it in. Here I'm going to remove the, oh, this is body, so I'm going to remove the thigh, leg, foot, and thigh. Leg and foot, so I only have the head and the shoulder rotation left. So this animation will only move the player here. So one more thing we could do would be the tail. So we could record, hit record, move all the way up here, and take the tail and move it upwards and back, and move it in so that hides there. So the tail will go up when he falls like that as well. Gonna stop recording. Go to legs. Fall, we don't have it yet, so let's create it, create new clip, animations, legs, and write legs underscore fall. Then I am going to paste it in here, and I'm going to remove everything with head, shoulders, I'm going to remove these and the arms, and there we go. So now we have the legs doing like this. Okay. We now have this correct setup, so let's go to animator. And find our animations for the body, our legs first. Take the leg fall and move it up here. Then I am going to make it transition from any state over here. And I'm going to set up the transition so that it has no transition duration and it doesn't have transition to self. Then I will go to parameters and add two new parameters, one called legs underscore fall. And I'm going to create another one called body underscore fall. Legs is going to stay up here and body is going to be at the bottom here. Then I will select the transition again between legs and any state, legs fall any state. Click the plus and say that if legs fall is true, then we transition here. I'll jump back to layer, select the body, and take this, take body fall, make a transition, select it, make sure that it uses body underscore fall. If it's true, then we transition, we remove the time here, fix duration and everything, and that's it. So now we have set up the animator correctly. We also need to fix the clips. So if we go to body, select body fall, we uncheck loop time. We go to legs, select legs fall, uncheck loop time. With that done, we need to open up our script. So let's go to the player utilities first of all. And when it's open, we can zoom in a bit. and we can make a new method. Inside player utilities, we're going to make a public method called handleAir. HandleAir is going to check if the player is falling and play the right animation. That means we also need to make a new method called isFalling. So how do we check if the player is falling or not? Well, the easiest way to check if we're falling is by making an if statement. And in that if statement, we can say player.components.rigidBody.velocity.y. So if the velocity is less than zero, well, then we return true. And this is only true if we're not grounded, so and is grounded, because at some point we need to have some moving platforms and the rigid body velocity will be negative even though we are grounded. So we need to make this isn't grounded check. Out here we return false. If I could write correctly, there we go. So this is our is falling. So in handleAir, if is falling is true, then we say player.components.animator.tryPlayAnimationBody_fall. So we try to play the body fall animation. We copy this, paste it underneath here, and write legs fall. So with that in place, we need to create or call this method first of all. And where do we call this method? Well, the best way to call the method would be inside the player utilities. So let's go to player. Find update, write utilities dot handle air. So now we're handling air. However, we need to add the method or the animation. So we just copy one of these and write body_fall. And we copy one of these and write legs_fall. So this should be enough for us to actually make the player fall. Let's try to save this and jump back into Unity. Look at our game and see what happens when we play it now. And you can see it started falling. However, it's too slow. So I'd like to take the body fall and set the speed to 2. Select it over here, set it to 2. I would like to go to legs and do the exact same thing and set the speed to 2. So now he goes whenever you jump. On the way down, he starts falling. Of course, this isn't perfect yet, because if we walk, he's not going to play the fall and walk jump animation, I mean. So this is also something we need to take into consideration later. But now our fox can jump and fall on his way down. So that's what I want to do in this video. Thank you so much for watching.